वंशकौपातरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभयैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासदि गौर भक्तवृन्द। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। So we're hearing how all the devotees came from Bengal. They came from Bengal, from Navadvip and the different villages around there. They all came to Jagannath Puri for Rath Yatra. And the king of Puri, he was amazed to see the devotees, to see all these devotees coming from Bengal. They were so effulgent and they were doing the most beautiful kirtan. So the Bhattacharya told the king, he said, this is called Prema Sankirtan. It means the chanting is done in love of God. And so then the Bhattacharya gave evidence from the scriptures to show that in the Kali Yuga, the Yuga Dharma, the process for the age of Kali, is chanting the holy name. He pointed out that Lord Chaitanya himself has come in the Kali Yuga to propagate the Yuga Dharma, to establish the chanting of the holy name. Intelligent people will take part in the chanting of the holy names, and people who don't chant the holy name, it's understood they're not intelligent. So then the king said, according to the information in the scriptures, we can see Lord Chaitanya is Lord Krishna himself. But the king said, we see sometimes that there's some learned scholars that they don't accept Lord Chaitanya as Krishna. So then the Bhattacharya said, yes, if they don't get the mercy from Lord Chaitanya, then they can never understand that he is Krishna. You have to get the mercy from Lord Chaitanya in order to understand who he is.
如果想要理解埃德尼亚的身份的话，必须得到他本人的仁慈。
And to spread the chanting of the holy names, you also need the mercy of Krishna.
要想传播唱诵圣名，也是需要主的仁慈。
If we want to awaken other people to Krishna consciousness, it can only be done with the mercy of Krishna.
如果想要唤醒别人来唱诵，来修习 Krishna 知觉，唤醒他们 Krishna 知觉的话，这也是这件事情也是需要得到主 Krishna 的仁慈才可以做到。
But if people don't understand Lord Chaitanya, then they'll never get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
倘若谁要是不理解是 Krishna Chaitanya 的身份，他就永远得不到他的仁慈。
You have to have faith in Lord Chaitanya, and you have to take part in the chanting and dancing in the sankirtan.
必须对 Chaitanya 有全然的信心，也必须要参与到在圣齐颂圣名当中的唱歌舞蹈。
You know, sometimes people may do chanting and dancing, but they just do it sentimentally. They don't have any real devotion. So this will not get them real Krishna consciousness.
我们看到有的人他们也参加唱诵舞蹈，但是他们是感情用事的在唱诵舞蹈，他们没有真正的奉爱，所以这个不是真正的 Krishna 知觉。
So even somebody may be very materially intelligent, he may be a scholar, and he may listen and he may watch, but he may not get the mercy of Lord. If he doesn't accept Lord Chaitanya, then he won't understand Lord Chaitanya's mercy.
在物质上有智慧的学者们，他们也许在那里旁观，或者是也听到了，但是如果他们不接受主 Chaitanya 的话，他们也不会理解主 Chaitanya， 也得不到他的仁慈。
They may even be initiated in the same sampradaya. They may be in the same sampradaya, but they may not get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
他们也许得到启迪，进入同一个 sampradaya 师徒传承，但是他们依然未能得到 Chaitanya 的仁慈。
And they may try to preach the holy name.But if they don't get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, they will never be successful. So we see sometimes people criticize the Krishna consciousness movement.
有时候我们看到有些人批评 Krishna 知觉的运动，
and they criticize even the leader of the Krishna, they criticize Prabhupada even.
他们甚至也指责圣帕帕德。
So this shows they didn't really have the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
这就表明他们根本没有得到 Chaitanya 的仁慈。
So then the king was looking and he saw the devotees, and he saw the devotees who came from Bengal, about 200 of them had come, and they were all going to see Lord Chaitanya. They went to the residence where Lord Chaitanya was staying. They didn't go into the temple to see Lord Jagannath, they just went to see Lord Chaitanya.
国王就注意到了有200位孟加拉的奉献者来到 Puri.他们都去见主 Chaitanya， 他们都到主 Chaitanya 的住所来去拜见主，但是他们并没有先去主加格纳的庙里。
So the king said, this is not the etiquette. They're supposed to, when people come, when pilgrims come to the holy place, there's certain things they're supposed to do. The first thing they're supposed to do is go see the deity.
王就说这不符合礼节。朝圣者他们来到圣地的时候，他们首先一件事应该是去见当神像。
But the Bhattacharya, he told the king, he said, you have to understand, they have spontaneous love. All the devotees, they're very anxious to meet Lord Chaitanya.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就回答国王说，他们是出于自发的爱，所有的奉献者都一切渴望的想要见到主 Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu。
So first the devotees will meet Lord Chaitanya and then they'll take him with them to the temple to see Lord Jagannath.
首先这些奉献者先去见 Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu， 然后他们会带着我本人跟他们一起去庙里去见 Jagannath。
And the king said, you know that the son of Bhavananda Roy, that's one of the brothers of Ramananda Roy, that he went along with five or seven men and they went to the temple to get prasadam for everyone.
国王就说，Bhavananda Roy 的儿子，他其中一个儿子，也就是 Ramananda Roy 的兄弟，他带了五个或七个人，他们就去Jagannath 的庙宇去得到 Jagannath 的 prasad。
And so this son of Bhavananda Roy, he went to the residence of Lord Chaitanya. He's taken a lot of Mahaprasadam there to give to all the devotees.
Bhavananda Roy 的他这个儿子就带了很多许许多多的鲫鱼，就去了主宰丹尼亚马哈巴布的住所。
So the king says, why is he doing like that?
国王感到非常的惊纳闷，说为什么他要这么做呢？
So the Bhattacharya told the king, he said, you have to understand that all the devotees have come to see Lord Chaitanya.
Bhattacharya 就回答说，您要明白，所有的奉献者都是来见主 Chaitanya 的。
So Lord Chaitanya, when he saw all the devotees coming, then he told his servant, go and bring prasadam for everyone.
当主 Chaitanya 看到所有的奉献者都到来的时候，他就命令他的仆人去拿很多许许多多的鲫鱼 prasadam.
So the king was surprised, and he said, what? He said, but...they're not following the proper regulations when you come to a holy place.
国王对此就感到非常惊讶，他说他们并没有遵守朝圣者来到圣地朝圣所需要遵守的恰当礼节。
Yeah, when you come to a holy place, first thing you're supposed to do, you're supposed to fast for the first night. You sleep, you stay there, and the very first night you don't eat anything.And you just fast the whole day?
朝圣者来到圣地，他们通常遵守的礼仪就是，他们在第一天晚上他们会戒食，他们整天都不吃不喝。
And then, so they fast for one night, and then they're supposed to also shave their head when they come.
那他们头一天晚上戒食了之后呢？他们还来到圣地，第一件事还应该去剃头。
But these devotees who've come from Bengal, they're eating prasadam right now.
是这些来自孟加拉的奉献者，他们一到了圣地就开始荣耀起 Mahaprasadam 了。
So the king was puzzled that these people from Bengal, they don't follow the etiquette, they don't follow the rules.
所以国王就对这些孟加拉的奉献者不遵守朝圣的礼节，他感到困惑。
So the Bhattacharya told the king, he said, yes, he said, what you're saying is right. He said, the regulative principles are like that. You go to visit a holy place, you have to follow those rules, like what you were saying. And they're supposed to fast for the one night. And then they wear the clothes, wear special, they're supposed to shave their heads. And they're supposed to take bath in the lake there, the holy place. But he said that's one way. That's the path of the regulative principles. But these devotees who've come from Bengal, they're more advanced. They're on the path of spontaneous love. So the path of spontaneous devotion is actually more pleasing to Krishna than the path of rules and regulations. The regulative principles are there for the ordinary people, the common people. Because the common people, they're not very devotional, they don't usually follow rules and regulations, and they do a lot of sinful things. They have a lot of sex at night, they can't sleep unless they have sex. So they need to have they need to follow the rules and regulations to purify themselves. Yeah, when he comes to the holy place, he should fast for the day, for the first day. And then he should shave his head clean. And we see the holy places, if you go to a holy place like Tirupati, you see all the family, the whole family will come and they will all shave their head, the men and the women and everyone. And then they should take a bath in the river or in the sea there at the holy place. So this helps them to get rid of a lot of their bad karma. Now, people come to a holy place for that, to change, to get rid of all their bad karma. So the holy places, they build up a lot of bad karma. All the people come there and leave all their bad karma there. But when a saintly person comes there, then he will take away all the bad karma.
一旦有圣人去了圣地，他就能拿走这些罪恶的恶报。
So the devotees who had come to see Lord Chaitanya, they were not common men. They were all very special devotees.
但是这些前来觐见主 Chaitanya 的奉献者都不是普通人，他们都是特殊的奉献者。
And so they had so much love for Lord Chaitanya that as soon as they came there, they immediately wanted to see Lord Chaitanya.
他们对主 Chaitanya 是满怀着满的奉爱之情，他们一到圣地就立刻就想见到主。
And Lord Chaitanya, he's Krishna, and he wants to give them prasadam, so they have to accept.
而主 Chaitanya 就是 Krishna 本人。他想给这些奉献者 prasadam 吃，所以这些奉献者就不得不接受。
Yeah, if Krishna gives you prasadam, you have to take it immediately. You have to eat it right away.
而 Krishna 给你 prasadam 的话，你必须得接受，而且马上就得吃掉。
So all of these rules and regulations for shaving and fasting, they're the orders of Krishna.
所以这些朝圣的规矩，包括剃头还有戒食，也都是 Krishna 的命令。
But Krishna also gives the order, take prasadam.
但是 Krishna 也下了命令，你要接受 prasadam。
Well, if there's no prasadam, then they can fast.
如果没有 prasadam 荣耀的话，那么就可以戒食。
But when Krishna gives prasadam, take the prasadam. If you don't take it, it's offensive.
假如 Krishna 给了 prasadam 的话，那就应当立即荣耀，否则话这也是一个冒犯。
So when Lord Chaitanya is distributing prasadam with his own hand, all the devotees would take. They didn't worry about fasting.
主柴丹家亲手给奉献者派普沙登的时候，他们立刻就接受了荣耀了，他们不担心，根本就不考虑要戒食这件事儿。
Just one minute. Just...Is today Ekadasi there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Today is Ekadasi.
Yeah, also here. Right. Okay, so Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya describes, he said one morning I was just getting up from bed. I was still sitting on my bed. I hadn't even got up. And Lord Chaitanya came to my home and he brought Mahaprasadam.
So
I hadn't even washed my mouth, but I immediately took the prasadam.
我甚至还没有漱口，但是在这种状态下，我仍然就马上荣耀了 prasadam.
So.When Krishna gives his mercy to the devotee, you have to take it.
倘若 Krishna 给予奉献者仁慈的话，那就要马上就要接受这份仁慈。
It's more important than all the rules and regulations, like fasting and shaving.
这比所有的包括戒食和剃头这种规范原则要更来得更加重要。
So Krishna's in everyone's heart, and when Krishna inspires the devotee like that, then it's very good. Yeah, if we just follow the rule and the regulations, then we will make advancement very slowly. Yeah, we get Krishna in the heart. He inspires us to go ahead and do things without following all the rules and regulations. So it's described like that. There's in the Srimad Bhagavatam, there's the example. There was this one king, King Prachinabari, and he was doing a lot of Vedic sacrifices, and Narada Muni told him not to do these sacrifices. If we want to get the mercy of Krishna, we have to develop that love for Krishna which goes beyond all the rules and regulations. So this conversation, this took place on the roof of the temple. They've been watching all the devotees come. So then the king decides, okay, he comes down from the roof and he goes to meet some of the people. He told some of the people who were doing the managing in charge of the temple of Jagannath Puri, he told them, he said, make sure all the devotees and all the associates of Lord Chaitanya get a nice place to stay and give them nice prasadam and make arrangements so that they can go to the temple and see the deities without any difficulty. And the king said, even Lord Chaitanya doesn't ask for anything, you should try to understand what is his desire. So then Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya comes to meet with Lord Chaitanya and to be with all the devotees. So Lord Chaitanya had not seen them for a long time, so he's very happy to meet them.
Chaitanya 跟他们已经好长时间没有见面了，所以他非常的高兴。
So they came out of the temple and they went to the place where Lord Chaitanya was staying at the home of Kasi Mishra.
所以他们就从庙那里走出来，又去了Chaitanya 居住的Kasi Mishra家。
So they met each other. Lord Chaitanya was coming with all of his associates, and he met all the Vaishnavas. They met together on the main road, and they were very ecstatic to meet each other.
Chaitanya 就带着他的同游们，就在主路上跟这些奉献者汇合了。当时的情景是非常狂喜的。
And Advaita Acharya, he offered prayers to Lord Chaitanya.And Lord Chaitanya embraced him.
Advaita Acharya 就向主献上了祈祷，而主立刻就拥抱了他。
But because they were in the middle of the road in the public place, they controlled their feelings.
但是因为当时他们是在主路上，在公共的场合，所以他们都克制了自己的情感。
Then all the devotees, they began to offer their prayers to Lord Chaitanya, and Lord Chaitanya would embrace each of them.
然后接下来所有的奉献者都一一向主 Chaitanya 献上祈祷，然后主 Chaitanya 一一拥抱了他们。
And then Lord Chaitanya brought them into the house, into the place where he was staying. But that place was not very big, so it was too crowded.
接下来主柴的面就把奉献者们带到他居住的房间，但是因为这房间不大，所以呢房间就因为奉献者很多显得很拥挤。
And they made the devotee, Lord Chaitanya had all the devotees sit at his side, and he would put flower garlands and sandalwood pulp on them.
Shri Krishna Chaitanya 就让所有的奉献者坐在他的身旁，然后他就亲手给他们献上了花环，戴上了花环和檀香浆。
So Sri Lord Chaitanya told Advaita Acharya, he said that today I have become perfect because of your arrival.
Sri Krishna Chaitanya 就对Advaita Acharya 说，今天我的生命完美了，因为您的到来，我的生命变完美了。
And Advaita Acharya, he says to Lord Chaitanya, he said, Oh, this is the nature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. He is complete, he's complete and full of opulence.
Now, Advaita Acharya 就对 Lord Chaitanya 说，这就是至尊性格神首的本性。他是完整和富裕的。
And he takes pleasure in being with his devotees.
但是他却因为跟他的奉献者待在一起而感到心满意足。
Then Lord Chaitanya saw Vasudev Datta, who is the older brother of Mukunda Datta.
那接下来是 Krishna Chaitanya 就看见了 Vasudeva Datta.
So Lord Chaitanya was very happy and he put his hand on his head and he began to speak. So Lord Chaitanya said,You know, Mukunda, your younger brother Mukunda, he was my friend from childhood, but I get more pleasure in seeing you than in seeing him.
然后是 Krishna Chaitanya 就对他说，你知道吗？你的弟弟 Mukunda 是我的发小，我俩从小就是朋友。但是我看见你比看见他更高兴。
So when Vasudev Datta said that, he said, well, my younger brother, he got your association in the beginning.
然后 Vasudeva 就回答说， 我的弟弟穆昆达，他比我早，他早于我一开始就得到了您的怜悯。
So he has already taken shelter at your lotus feet.
他已经躲避了您的莲花足。
So he's already been reborn.
他已经得到了第二次的诞生。
But then Vasudeva Datta, then he describes, he said, I'm inferior to my younger brother. I'm not as great, he's better than me. Although Mukunda is my younger brother, but he was the first one to get your favor. He got your mercy before me. So transcendentally, he's senior to me. And I know also that you gave a lot of mercy to my younger brother Mukunda. So he's superior to me in all the good qualities. So then Lord Chaitanya changed the subject and he said, you know, I brought two books from South India with me. He said, the two books are being kept with Swarup Damodar, and you can get them copied. So Vasudeva Datta was very happy, he was very excited to hear this, two new books. So all the devotees, everybody who'd come with Lord Chaitanya, they all got copies of the two books. One book was the Brahma Samhita. Lord Chaitanya found this book in the temple called the Adi Keshava Temple. It's in South India, in the state of Kerala. And so when Lord Chaitanya heard the subject matter of Brahma Samhita, he was very pleased and he got copies written for himself to bring. And he gave copies to, he met Ramananda Roy got copies, and then he gave copies to all the devotees. And the other book was a book by Bilvamangal Thakur called Krishna Karanamrita. So the devotees were very happy to get new books by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya.
见者都很高兴，这出差在那的仁慈得到了两本书。
So then Lord Chaitanya met with Srivas Pandit, and Srivas Pandit had come there with his brothers, all together, they are four brothers.
接下来我又见到了 Srivas 和 Pandit 的 他们兄弟四个都来了。
So Lord Chaitanya told them, he said, I am purchased by you four brothers.
我就告诉他们，我被你们兄弟四个人给购买了。
But Srivas Pandit said, No, why are you speaking like this? We four brothers, we have been purchased by your mercy.
Srivas 就对主回答说，您为什么要这样说呢？相反，我们兄弟四个是被您的仁慈所购买了，收买了。
Then Lord Chaitanya spoke to Damodar Pandit, and he said to Damodar Pandit, he said, my affection for you is on the platform of awe and reverence.
接下来主 Chaitanya
Mahaprabhu
又对这Damodar Pandit 说，我对你的爱在敬畏的层面上。
The Lord's affection towards his younger brother, this Damodar Pandit had a younger brother, and Lord Chaitanya had a different mood. He had pure love for that younger brother, but for the older brother, it was on reverence.
Damodar Pandit, he has a brother. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 对他弟弟的情感是纯粹的爱的情感，但是他对于Damodar Pandit 是另外一种情感。
Damodar Pandit sometimes would be very, he would look for faults and he would criticize that, oh, this is not good, oh, shouldn't do. He would find faults sometimes with Lord Chaitanya.
他有的时候会持批评的态度，会挑错，挑出柴丹尼亚的错。
But the younger brother of Damodar Pandit, he had pure love for Lord Chaitanya.
可是达摩达尔潘迪的弟弟却对主柴丹尼亚怀着纯粹无瑕的爱，奉爱。
And so when Damodar Pandit heard that, he said, from today on,My younger brother has become my older brother because of your special mercy. Then Lord Chaitanya met with Shivananda Sen, who was a very great devotee, who.Had a lot of intimate association with Lord Chaitanya. So when Lord Chaitanya spoke to Shivananda Sen, Shivananda Sen fell on the ground and offered prayers to Lord Chaitanya.
当主柴丹娘对希伯南德森呢说话的时候，开口说话的时候，希伯南德森呢就倒在拜倒在地上，向主献上祈祷。
Then Murari Gupta was another very intimate devotee of Lord Chaitanya. He'd known Lord Chaitanya since he was a child, and he met Lord Chaitanya.
Murari Gupta 是。主柴丹尼亚从小的时候就认识主柴丹尼亚，接下来就是他又跟主见面。
But Murari Gupta is very humble. He didn't like to go in the front. He didn't like to go near to Lord Chaitanya. He all the devotees were inside. He was outside.
谦卑，他并不想凑到前面，离我很近，他没有留在屋里，相反他在屋外。
So Lord Chaitanya was asking, where's Murari Gupta? And the devotees were going outside and they were calling, Murari, where are you? Lord Chaitanya wants to see you, come. So Murari Gupta is very humble and he got some straw in his teeth and he came near to Lord Chaitanya. And when Lord Chaitanya saw him, Murari went to run away. he didn't want Lord Chaitanya to touch him. He ran away. He was afraid that he said, I'm so sinful. I'm not fit for you to touch me. I'm very sinful. I don't want you to have to touch me. But Lord Chaitanya embraced him and then he made him sit beside him. And then Lord Chaitanya began to cleanse his body with his own hands. Then there were so many devotees there. The Lord Chaitanya said, where's Haridas? What about Haridas Thakur? And then he saw in the distance, he saw Haridas was very far away in a distant place, and he was on the floor offering obeisances. So the devotees went to Haridas and they told him, Lord Chaitanya wants to meet you, you should come immediately.
Sorry.
Okay, you got a cold, huh? He said, I can't go near the temple. I'm very low. I'm very thin, very untouchable. I just need to get a place somewhere near the temple and I can be there. I don't want any of the servants of Lord Jagannath to have to touch me. That would not be good. So Lord Chaitanya was very happy to hear about the humility of Haridas. So then the head of the temple, of Jagannath temple, they came and they met all the devotees and they're very happy to see all the devotees. And so they asked, where do you want us to stay?
And 管理者就来见了所有的奉献者，他们彼此都非常高兴。后来，然后他就问，你希望我们待在哪里？
And then they said, now we're going to distribute Mahaprasadam for all of you. We brought Mahaprasadam from Lord Jagannath. We want all of you. You should take your prasadam.
这庙的管理者就对奉献者说，我们带了Mahaprasadam，我们希望给你们拜 Mahaprasadam。
So then Lord Chaitanya said, near my place, in the garden, there's a little room there which is very quiet.
然后主柴丹念就说，在我的住所附近呢有一个花园，那里非常安静。
So Lord Chaitanya said, please let me have that room because I need it. And then I can remember the lotus feet of Lord Jagannath sitting in the quiet place. It's not clear if that place, if Lord Chaitanya wanted for himself, maybe he wanted it for himself or he wanted it for Haridas Thakur. But it shows it's important to get a nice place, quiet place where you can sit and chant a holy name.
So it's not clear whether this room is for Chaitanya Mahaprabhu or Haridas Thakur.
Yeah.
But it shows that, okay.
But Prabhupada said this is not for neophyte devotees, this is only for very, very advanced devotees. And Prabhupada didn't want us to give up our preaching just to sit and chant in a quiet place. Because our senses are very strong. And if we don't keep our mind and senses properly controlled, then we'll get into Maya. So Prabhupada said, preaching work is also for advanced devotees. And later on, you may retire to chant the holy name. But don't try to imitate spiritual life. Don't try to do this prematurely. So then the head of the temple told Lord Chaitanya, he said, everything belongs to you. What is the use? You don't have to ask me for anything, that you can take whatever you want.
无论您想要什么，您不叫来征求我们的意见，您直接拿去用就好了。
Just tell us what you want, and we're very happy to provide it for you.
无论您想需要什么，您就直接提出要求，我们会很高兴给您提供的。
So then, they give a lot of prasadam to all the devotees.
所以他们就给奉献者许许多多的大量的普沙的。
And then they said, now you can all go to your place, and then you can go to the sea and take bath in the sea.
然后主就对奉献者说，现在你们都可以去你们各自的地方，然后去海中沐浴。
And from the sea, you can see the top of the temple. So by seeing the top of the temple, it's like having a darshan of the temple.
你们在海中远远的能眺望到这庙的顶端，然后当您眺望到这庙的顶尖的时候呢，就相当于你们已经darshan了这神庙了。
So then they said, after you've taken your bath, then come back here, we'll have prasadam.
那你们从海中沐浴回来之后，我们就可以开始荣耀 prasadam 了。
And then Lord Chaitanya saw Haridas, that Haridas was already, he was chanting the Maha Mantra. He was absorbed in his chanting.
然后主持人那样又看到了 Haridas Thakur,这时候他已经开始专注地念诵他的圣名了。
And when Haridas saw Lord Chaitanya, then Haridas offered obeisances. He fell on the ground at his feet.
当 Haridas 看见主之后，立刻就直挺挺地倒在地上，向主的莲花足顶拜。
But Lord Chaitanya embraced him, and the two of them they began to cry. Both Haridas and Lord Chaitanya were in tears.
但是主柴特尼亚就把他扶起来，拥抱了他，他们都哭泣起来，他们两个人都流下了泪。
So Lord Chaitanya is the master, and Haridas Thakur is the servant, but they both have love for each other.
柴特尼亚嘛，他不是主人 ，Haridas Thakur 是仆人，但是尽管如此，他们彼此间都怀着深深的爱意。
So, although Lord Chaitanya is the master, he appreciates his servants, and he's happy, very happy with a servant like Haridas Thakur.
尽管是柴特尼亚马哈巴布是主人，但是他很欣赏 Haridas Thakur, 他很高兴，他对 Haridas Thakur 非常满意，很高兴见到他。
But Haridas Thakur says, oh, I'm very sinful, don't touch me, I'm the lowest, I'm very impure.
Haridas Thakur 就恳求主说，请不要触碰我，我非常罪恶，我是最低贱的，我是不可触碰的。
And Lord Chaitanya says, I just want to purify myself by touching you.
我对 Haridas Thakur 说，我希望通过触碰你来净化我自己。
So, we should touch a pure devotee like Haridas, just to purify ourselves.
我们应该去触碰像 Haridas Thakur 这样的纯粹奉献者，以便净化我们自己。
Actually, they're both pure. Haridas is pure and Lord Chaitanya is pure. They don't need to purify themselves.
事实上，他们两个人都是纯洁无瑕的。Haridas Thakur 是纯净的，主也是纯净的，他们根本就不需要净化。
So Lord Chaitanya told Haridas, he said, "I know that you take bath in all the holy places of pilgrimage, all the time, at every moment you take bath."In all the holy places.
如柴丹丹的妈帕布就对哈尔达斯塔库说，事实上我知道你每时每刻都在所有的朝圣之地都在那里沐浴。
And you're always studying the four Vedas. And you're much better than any Brahmin or Sannyasi.
你也恒常的在研习着伟达经，你比任何婆罗门和多波僧都更好。
Then Lord Chaitanya quoted the verse from the Srimad Bhagavatam, which describes like that.
接下来，柴达涅玛哈布就引述了
that even one's born in a family of dog eaters, but if he's chanting the holy name, it's understood he did all of these things in his past life. So then Lord Chaitanya brought Haridas and he showed him that room and he told him, you stay here and chant Hare Krishna. And Lord Chaitanya said, every day I will come here and bring you Mahaprasadam and I will meet you every day. And you can, from here, you can see the top of the temple. So that, because Haridas Thakur, he cannot go in the temple because he's a Muslim by birth. So he's not allowed, he wasn't allowed to go in the temple. But he could see the top of the temple. And the top of the temple, the chakra on the top of the temple, that's as good as seeing the deity in the temple. So Lord Chaitanya was giving the order to Haridas Thakur to stay there and chant. But different devotees got different instructions. Some people got told to go and preach. Some people got told to stay in Jagannath Puri. So whatever order you get from the spiritual master, you should take it very seriously. So then Lord Chaitanya also went to take bath in the sea. And Advaita also, they all went to bathe in the sea. Lord Chaitanya, he would take bath in the sea 3 times every day. It's a regulative principle for the sannyasi. And then they went to Lord Chaitanya's place to take their lunch. So Lord Chaitanya would personally distribute prasadam to them with his own hand. And Lord Chaitanya would give everyone enough for 2 or 3 people. The devotees were all, oh no, it's too much. But Lord Chaitanya said, no, I cannot give any less. You have to eat. So nobody was eating. They said, why are you not eating? They said, because first you should sit and you eat. After you sit and eat, then we will eat. So other devotees, they they began to distribute prasadam, and they made Lord Chaitanya sit down and take prasadam.
有其他的奉献者带prasadam，然后就让主Chaitanya坐下来开始荣耀。Okay,
so we will stop here. Maybe we'll are there some questions?
Yes. 那我们就讲到这里，接下来我们看一下问题。第一个问题是。 真问 Hare Krishna， 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj， 顶拜您甜美的莲花祖，顶拜所有奉献者。如果有个人给过我很多仁慈，又说了一些伤害我的话，我该怎么面对这种关系呢？ Then said Hare Krishna, dear Guru Maharaj， obeisance to your sweet lotus feet， obeisance to all devotees。 If there is somebody who has given me a lot of mercy, at the same time has said something that's very hurting to my heart, how can I face this relationship?
Well, we have to be tolerant.
我们要容忍.
If somebody is giving you mercy, and at the same time you feel sometimes pain by what they say, maybe the problem is more with your mind. Maybe what they said was not really, maybe you took what they said the wrong way. Sometimes it's just in our mind that we feel offended, but they didn't actually mean any offense. So we cannot be too sensitive. Sometimes we're very sensitive, you know. And we have to understand there's the good and there's the bad. There's the winter and there's the summer. So sometimes you get, you know, people say nice things and sometimes they say things which are not so nice.
有的时候话就是有好话，有的时候呢，有的时候也不是那么好的。
So, you enjoyed when they said something good. So you have to also you have to accept it when they say something which is not very good.
那如果他们说了好听的话，你感到很享受，但是你就应当做好这种接受他们。
You have to control your mind. Don't get too much disturbed. Somebody says something good to you, don't rejoice. And in the same way, somebody says something bad to you, not very pleasing, don't lament.
别人对您说了好话，你也不要沾沾自喜高兴；倘若别人说了一些不好听的话，不那么悦耳动听的话，你也不要感到难过、伤心。
You have to become, you have to learn to be indifferent, not to be so easily disturbed by the words which people say to each other.
你要学会，变得。
So, if somebody says something good to you, actually somebody says something good to you, it's not good for you, because you become proud. You think, yes, I'm very good, I'm great.
事实上呢，倘若别人就是对您说了一些非常的奉承话，就是不好的，反而不是件好事儿，
But
会使您变得骄傲，您就觉得自己特了不起、特伟大。
Somebody says something which is not pleasing to you, you should thank them. That thank you very much. It will help me to be a better devotee. I'll become more humble.
倘若有人呢，您说了，说了您的坏话，您应该感谢他。您呢，因为他们会帮助您成为更好的奉献者，变得更谦卑。
So the person who praises you, he's not really your friend. It's the one who finds fault with you. He's really the friend.
事实上，那个赞美您的人不是您的朋友，那个挑您错的人才是您的朋友。
嗯哼。还有问题？
还有，下一个是上节课的问，好像上节课的问题 ，Rady。像顶拜孤乳顶拜所有奉献者，请问孤乳，有奉献者说他平时上班觉得自己念诵质量不够好，他想在休息这天正好又是 Ekadasi 念诵提高 Japa 质量，可这天又有Kirtan活动，这个奉献者只是自己单独念诵呢，还是去参加 Kirtan， 哪个更重要啊？
Well, they have to chant, they have to do their minimum rounds, they have to do the minimum rounds which they're supposed to do. Like on Ekadasi, usually we would try to do 25 rounds. On ordinary days, we do 16 rounds. But on Ekadasi, you should try to do more chanting.
那这个奉献者应当就是念诵最少念诵他的基本的圈数，在以卡斯这天基本的圈数是25圈，在平日的基本的圈数是16圈。
So kirtan, of course, when we get time, we join the kirtan.
那至于 kirtan 呢？如果有时间可以去加入。
But you have to do your duties. You have to do the basic duties like daily chanting. You have to chant your rounds, the minimum number of rounds. You have to do that, and you have to also do your work, do your job.
但是作为奉献者呢，应该履行自己的基本责任，就是每天念诵他最少要念诵的圈数。与此同时，他还要上班工作。
And kirtan, yeah, whenever we get time, we'll do kirtan.
那至于 kirtan, 就是唱一诵圣名呢，有时间可以去 kirtan.
We can always be hearing kirtan. We have so many recordings of kirtan. You could be playing the recordings and hearing.
您可以听这个，奉献者。听 Kirtan， 聆听 Kirtan， 有那么多 Kirtan 的录音，他可以听这些录音。
OK， 还有问题吗？
没有吧？
哦、uh-huh. ，
但是没有了。
OK， so we can go back to the text. We just about finished the chapter. So we were hearing how all the devotees they got prasadam from Lord Chaitanya. So they gave to all the sannyasis and then they distributed to all the devotees.And Lord Chaitanya gave prasadam to Govinda. He told Govinda, Govinda is the servant of Lord Chaitanya. He said, make sure you give this to Haridas Thakur.
把一些 prasadam 交给狗，他的仆人 的，就吩咐狗温的把这个普沙灯给哈瑞达斯塔库。
So then Lord Chaitanya sat down with all the sannyasis to take prasadam together.
Chaitanya 随后就和一些 sannyasi 坐在一起，共同荣耀普沙的。
And they had all kinds of nice prasadam. They had a lot of sweet rice and cakes, different kinds of cakes. And everybody was chanting the holy name. You could hear the holy name being chanted all the time.
有各式各样的普沙的，还有各式各样的点心和甜米饭，然后同时呢，奉献者也可以听到此起彼伏的唱诵圣名的声音。
People who are not pious, they cannot understand the value of Mahaprasadam.
不虔诚的人，他们不能明白 Mahaprasadam 的重要意义。
But actually, prasadam and the holy name of Krishna are both very spiritual.
但事实上呢 ，prasada 连同 Krishna 的圣名都是灵性的。
So you should never consider prasadam to be ordinary food.
永远不要把 prasada 当成普通食物。
And we shouldn't take any food which is not offered to Krishna.
我们绝不要吃任何没有供奉过的食物。
So all the devotees took their prasadam, and after prasadam, then they washed their hands and mouth, and then Lord Chaitanya came again to distribute flower garlands and sandalwood pulp.
所有的奉献者他们都荣耀了 prasadam, 最后他们漱口，他们净手。Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 又前来奉献者，给他们带花环和檀香浆。
So they took after the prasadam, they went to take some rest, and in the evening they came back to be with Lord Chaitanya again to have kirtan.
奉献者随后呢就回到各自的住处去休息。到了晚上，他们前来和主 Chaitanya 一起进行 kirtan。
And Lord Chaitanya also introduced Ramananda Roy to all the devotees.
Chaitanya 也向所有的奉献者介绍了 Ramananda Roy.
And then he took everybody to the temple to go and see Lord Jagannath, and they had a big kirtan there.
最后，主就带领所有的奉献者前往主迦格纳的庙宇，那里举行了盛大的 kirtan.
And Lord Chaitanya divided the party, divided devotees into four groups, and they went in different directions.
Chaitanya 把奉献者们分成了四组，一些奉献者就来去了不同的方向。
And in the four groups, each group there were two madangas.
每一组有两个 mridanga鼓。
And then there were 32 people playing kartals.
还有32位奉献者打挠钹。
So they had 8 madangas and 32 kartal players. So it made a lot of noise.
所以总共呢就有八个每当家鼓，还有32副挠钹，所以这样就是鼓声震天。
The sound was so great, it went everywhere, it covered all the 14 planet systems.
所以这个声音呢，直冲云霄，覆盖了14个星系。
Oh, when the people in Jagannath Puri heard the kirtan, everybody came running, they wanted to see, they wanted to take part.
Jagannath Puri 所有人听到这个乐团声呢都跑过来想看个究竟，想参加进来。
And when they saw it, they said, wow, we never saw kirtan like this before. This is incredible.
当他们看到这幕情景的时候呢，他们都连声赞叹说，我们从来没有见过这样的景象，这简直太不可思议了。
So Lord Chaitanya, he was running around the temple. He was going around the temple.And at the same time, he was singing and dancing.
Chaitanya 呢就绕着这个庙，绕环绕绕拜这个庙。与此同时，他载歌载舞。
And the four kirtan parties, they were following Lord Chaitanya.
四个 kirtan 队伍就尾随着主 Chaitanya。
One party was in front, one party was at the back, and two were on each side.
一个 kirtan 队伍在主的前面，一个 kirtan 队伍在主的身后，还有主的两边各有一个 kirtan 队伍。
Sometimes Lord Chaitanya would fall down and Lord Nityananda would pick him up.
有时候主柴的娘会倒在地上，主尼加南达会帮主扶起来。
And Lord Chaitanya's body was in ecstasy. He was trembling and perspiring.
主的身体就展现出狂喜的征兆。他有的时候浑身颤抖，有的时候他浑身流汗。
And what is it was tears were coming from his eyes.And his tears were like water coming from a syringe, and it would soak everybody near him.
泪水就从主的眼眶中喷流而出，就好像是喷泉一样，会把他四周的奉献者的衣服都打湿。
So then Lord Chaitanya went to the back of the temple, and they kept doing kirtan.And then Lord Chaitanya began to dance, and he was jumping high and higher.
我就来到，随后来到了庙的后面。这时候乐坛与此同时呢都在进行着，我跳了起来，他就跳到半空当中，他跳得越来越高。
And so then Lord Chaitanya got the other people to dance, like Lord Nityananda began to dance.And Advaita Acharya also danced.
Lord Chaitanya 也让其他的奉献者在跳舞，他让 Nityananda 他不跳舞，让 Advaita Acharya 跳舞。
And then Vrikeshwara Pandit was dancing, and Srivas Pandit was dancing. They were all great dancers.
Vrikeshwara Pandit 开始跳舞 ，Srivas Thakur 也开始跳舞，他们都是伟大的舞蹈者。
And while they were dancing, Lord Chaitanya did a miracle. He was in the middle of all the devotees dancing. And he could see everyone at the same time. He could see everyone.Because everyone wanted to get Lord Chaitanya's glance, so Lord Chaitanya was able to show everyone that he was seeing everyone.
每一个人都想得到主的瞥视，然后主呢，他就在所有人的所有舞者的中央。
So everybody was very happy to see so much love and the wonderful Sankirtan.People were all in ecstasy.
所有人呢都感受到了巨大的爱，他所有人都感觉到狂喜。
And the king was watching also from his palace. He could see from his palace. He could see what was going on. He was amazed to see all the kirtan.
国王就站在他的宫殿，就注视着这一幕幕场景，他就聆听着这kirtan声，感到非常的惊讶。
And the king became more eager to meet with Lord Chaitanya again.
国王就变得更加的渴望要亲，就面对面的和主会面。
Okay, so this is the pastime of Lord Chaitanya described in chapter 11. Tomorrow we'll hear about the cleaning of the Gundicha temple.
所以今天讲的就是第十一章的内容，明天我们将听到拱地产清洁拱地产庙的消失光。Here is a question.
Oh, okay.
Chen Chen continued to ask Hare Krishna, 亲爱的 Guru Maharaj, 请拜您甜美莲花指，请拜所有奉献者。那我怎么才能变得不那么敏感呢？这一点我控制不了啊，很苦恼。Chen Chen said, how can I be not so sensitive? I cannot control. I felt very afflicted.
Who's asking this question?
It's devotee. He said,
what's the name?
Zhenzhen.
Zhenzhen. Oh, Zhenzhen.
Yes.
Okay. Well, you just have to learn to become more tolerant. You can't be so sensitive all the time. Just like we have to tolerate the heat and the cold. So you have to tolerate the good and the bad.
我们要学会容忍，就像有冷有热，我们也要对好坏容忍。
So even though you don't feel, maybe you don't like it when somebody criticizes you, but still you should tell them, you should say, oh, thank you very much. You're helping me to improve, to make me a better devotee. So thank you very much.
您不喜欢听到批评的话，您也要对对方说，非常感谢您，您帮助我进步，成为一个更优秀的奉献者。So
you can talk to them like that. You can say, you can appreciate them. That thank you for pointing out my faults. That I'm so foolish. I only think of my good qualities, but you see my faults. So thank you very much.
所以就是您可以跟他们说话，您可以跟他们说，就是非常欣赏您指出我的缺点，我特别愚蠢，我只看到我自己的优点，但是您给我指出了我的缺点，我非常非常感谢您。
Yeah, we can't be so sensitive all the time.
我们不能就是总是那么敏感。
There will always be good and bad. There will be praise and there will be abuse. People will honor you and other people will dishonor you. You have to just tolerate, you have to accept that.
有好也有坏，就也有坏，有赞扬的，也有那侮辱。您要容忍，要接受。
You have to see that there's some good, although you may not like what they're saying. Actually, it's good for you.
您能看到这种事情的好的一面，虽然您内心不喜欢，但事实上呢。
So you have to control your mind by chanting Hare Krishna. And you have to remember also when people say things to you, you have to remember that you're not the body. And you're not the mind either. You're a spirit soul. So somebody says something to you, one day you like it, and someday another person can say the same thing to you, and you may not like it. The mind is like that.
某些人呢，跟你说了同样的话。 那可能今天您听了这个人说的话，您感到很高兴，但是换一天，另外一个人说同样的话，您可能就不喜欢，就是心意就是这种这样。
So you have to really chant Hare Krishna very, very carefully. Call out to Krishna, help me control my mind, fix me in the consciousness that I'm a spirit soul. And I'm living in a material body.
对，你要非常小心的念唱诵 Hare Krishna，呼唤 Krishna，请求 Krishna 而帮助您控制心意，让您能够专注于念诵，让您能明白您是灵魂，您不是您的物质身体。
Okay, so you think about this is important. You think, remember this.
So you need to consider this very important.
And somebody says something you don't like, you can thank them. Thank you very much for helping me to improve, to make me a better person. Okay, we have to stop.
Yuna has a question now.
What does she want?
She said, Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj and devotees, if a senior devotee insults other junior Vaishnavas in our presence, how should we behave towards that senior devotee and those he has insulted, and what should we think of that senior devotee? 这个 Yuna 的问题是 Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj 的奉献者，接受我卑微顶拜。倘若一个年长奉献者在我们面前侮辱了一位年轻奉献者，那我们对待这位年长奉献者的行为举止应该是怎样的？我们怎么对待那被他侮辱的那个年轻奉献者？我们对这样的资深奉献者，我们应当是怎么有什么看法？怎么想？
You should continue to offer respects to him within the mind because he's chanting the holy name.
你要继续在您的心意里向这位资深奉献者致敬，因为他唱诵圣名，唱诵圣名。
But at the same time, you associate with him only at a distance. You don't get close to him.
但是与此同时呢，您跟他的联谊要保。
Like that.
这样。
Okay. Soyo Vamaganshya Guru Mani, Ke Vamajantai Defani, Vamaganshya Soyo Defunctionsa Lingting, Chufu Niman, Jerik Kwaila, Ming Tian Jian, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
好，我们感谢Guru Day 给我们精彩的讲课，感谢所有奉献的聆听 ，Hare Krishna。